to get the rugged look of imperfection that comes out of being a real weapon, it doesn't matter if the top is not perfectly combined, and if you can see a bit of the glue there, I'm gonna put more decorations on top that cover up that part and make it look more metallic and more intricate when you look inside, when you, for example, put a blade plug. And it's gonna keep on getting more objects on top of each other anyway, which cover again. Now we put the protection fins here. So with that, I have to go make a hole a bit bigger. Add glue as much as you can again without showing it, otherwise it becomes horrible. And here you go. Make sure that the longer part is at the top. That's the other thing. I had it before, and this glue is actually so strong you can't remove it. I broke the previous fins, although they were, well, badly printed, so it didn't really matter. It was still heartbreaking to see something printed for a while snap when you're trying to remove it and do something with it. Right. It's a few seconds, you don't need to do much. Put another hole in the other fin. Also fill in from the top of it. Glue will fall gravity, so it will go down anyway. It's a lot more game accurate. I'm not done with it. I still don't like this empty space, which is supposed to make it slimmer, but somehow it makes it cheaper. So I got a bit of leather strip. Doesn't have to be the expensive type, it can be cheap. I mean, this one's £5, something like that. Yeah, it's very cheap. And just do a couple of twists around it, so like that, a bunch of it. Cut it. And then, again, use the hot glue to deal with it. Do a little bit on one side. On top. I was abundant with it on purpose because I wanted to make a bit of a twist around. texture, otherwise the leather will come off. Looking a lot more Jedi-like. That's it for this part. This is just the external part, and we're gonna do the insides. So as you can see, it's still empty inside, but feeling heavy already. Good for a fight. Now, the other complicated thing that I needed to do is join the hilt together with the handle. And, well, not that precise, but I don't want to glue them together because I want to be able to remove them. So what I'm going to do is add metal straps held by little bolts on the thicker parts. And I'll show you how. So basically, let's put it down like this, and like that. Need something to hold it up. Something flat. Let's try like this. Alright. Alright, so what I need to do is take one of these things first. These are metal brackets, and just check where they finish, where they meet the ends. So here I can have one. So just make a little hole. So I'm quickly place inside this bolt. So it gets stuck inside while the plastic is getting colder. Help the direction of the pliers. So once this bolt is inside, secure it with a bit of glue so it doesn't come out. And move it so it stays in the right position. Alright, that's a straight bolt. Opposite side, do the same thing. So little hole exactly from the opposite direction. Ah, I need to get the bolt first. Otherwise I won't have time to place it in before the plastic gets cold. Alright, so bolt here. This is a quick job. Trying to make the entire thing symmetrical, that's why. Trying to be as precise as I can. few bolts, and some of them are longer than others. I think I took the wrong one. It's fine. Right, so you have these two little bolts now sticking out from here, and you add a bit of glue just to make sure that it stays where it is. You don't want it moving around for the next step. So, as you saw before, I'm gonna just place this one here, like that. Once it's in place, you get its other part, little dice, and I managed to get the only one that had glue in the middle. This is lucky, out of a million of them that I have, I got the one that was messed up. Alright, so this one goes here. And now, I lose it. I think I took the wrong one. Okay. Always figure out the right sizes before you do anything, otherwise you spend hours trying to do something that won't work anymore. Alright, so once it's set in, just screw it until the end. So you can imagine what the next step is. Taking the hilt, taking the right measurement, and making a hole. So, when you know that you're more or less in the right position, you make a little hole in the hilt too. Right, so pass through there. Yeah, cut through it. This one's gonna be a bit thicker, so and taller. Use a longer screw for this one. And now it's too slow. It's really cold. With this type of plastic, it's that it gets could have gone the other way around and just placed them inside and then sticking them out. But the problem is, I don't want to have anything blocking the chassis inside. So, I'm dealing with it this way. A little bit my finger. This has to pass. There you go. Pass through. Actually a lot thinner than I expected, so hopefully this plastic bit will actually fit without problems. Okay, so once it's inside, and there's no plastic blocking that screw. Let's see if we can cut it in. Make sure that they're not loose. You don't want them to come off while you're maybe fighting or carrying them around, because you're not gonna be happy if everything falls to the floor after. I'd recommend you put two bolts in the second one because it's thinner, so that will block it from ever moving. We have one side, we need the other one. So another one of these here. Bolts. This. Make sure when you're making the hole for the second one that it's not at an angle. You see here? It's falling on the side. You have to make sure that it holds like this after. We're gonna deal with the inside there after. The right holes. Alright, so let's get in. I don't want to put my finger in the middle. I straight as I would like it to be. Basically, it's falling on one side, and I'm gonna fill that side with glue so that it creates this thickness. It doesn't allow it to fall. And the glue was off. Wait a few seconds. Again. Yeah. So now the glue itself is holding contraption down. Yeah. Holding straight now. Yeah. Very good. Straight. Now, what I'm going to do here is fill up this side with glue so that I have something to work with. This side. So axis. Straight in all directions. The problem is it's gonna glue the hilt in position, and that's what we want to a certain point, but not forever. We want to be able to remove it. So what I'm gonna do is wait until the glue is hard enough and then pull it off, so it leaves the thickness. Doesn't make it permanent. Testing if it's smooth enough. Let's put inside this little baby and see how it works. Yeah, it went in and came out. Now something happened here. Oh, the leather came off. Okay, so the glue didn't hold it properly. Need to place it. I think I need to place the glue a bit more on the plastic than I did on the leather, and it didn't hold. So I'm gonna do it here on the plastic. This time the leather stays. Alright, so it seems like the glue has finally solidified here. So we're gonna just snap it again. The whole purpose of this glue is not holding things together, is making sure the thickness is the right one. Okay, there you go. Pull it off. Okay, pull it off again. external part of the lightsaber. Now I just noticed that the entry point here is quite thin, thick actually, so I'll probably have to snap off this part because I need a chassis to enter easily. So I have two alternatives, either snap it off or melt it, and melting it looks very messy, so I'm gonna try snapping it off. The appropriate pliers. See if it presses through. Not snugly, so let's remove a bit more. Okay, so it's passing through. Wait. A bit of a messy work at the bottom, but it can be cleaned up. And yeah, so it snugly fits the end tip. I left it a bit rough on purpose here because I want to have that full and order feeling. Now here I'm wondering if I should or should not close it, because I mean, leaving the handle detachable is because you can't access the inside of the handle normally, but I have actual doors here where you can access different parts of the handle. So what would be the point of not closing it? See how it looks. See, it's quite heavy. heavy and resistant already. Slightly bigger than the average lightsaber, but it allows a lot more modifications inside. Also, I've seen bigger than this in Star Wars. And if you do it double, well, this is gonna look insanely cool. And I'm gonna give it the possibility of changing to double here. I'm not gonna glue this part. Alright, so let's see, how much of this do we need? Let's do it like this. Using hot glue like anything, but yeah, it's worth it. Thank you. here the excess glue is visible at the bottom, but it's going to be closed by a cage, so nothing to worry about. But I want to be pedantic as usual, and then to the last bit, I'll glue off where it doesn't have to show. Trying to be careful not to rip the one under because that one's holding the leather. Okay, let's have a look at how it feels. To me. Yeah. A very rugged looking Jedi instrument. Actually quite excited to put the parts inside. I think it's gonna come out well. Anyway, I'm just gonna do the heel, the pommel, which is more or less the same thing as here, but I'm not gonna do it with the glue so that it can be removed whenever it's needed. And that's it.